Now we are not making that claim about Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We're saying when we pray to him, we're not saying, and this very...
Yeah, he prays to dead Muhammad. He says he's Muhammad. You pray to no other apart from God. You've admitted that you pray to Muhammad. And what we're saying is that if you pray to Muhammad, prayer only belongs to God.
I say if.
Daniel, what?
Daniel, may Allah be Allah's mercy be on you. If I say that, am I praying to you or praying for you? Why we say that? Because Allah said that to us. So we say it, saying to him direct, but the angels will take what we said. Abbas have said this for you. I'm already in the camera.
Your speaker's corner, bro. CCTV's everywhere.
I'm not afraid. Hello, guys. I got a lot of fans there.
Yeah? They're all in CP. Yeah?
They love Abbas.
They know you from CP. One day, they're going to all convert back from CP into that. Because you know what CP is doing?
He's not following CP.
Yeah, I know you're not. He's making a lot of fruitcakes. So when they're going to come and talk, bring same question of CPs, they're going to be demolished.
Be careful what you're saying, because CP is going to expose you.
Whatever you're saying, just be careful. You know why he don't let me speak?
He does.
No.
He
does. You're speaking nonsense. Anyway, go.
Give me one. No. Give me one. Again, my question to you is, you agree with me, the prophet of God would not lie and would not give false prophecy. Yes?
No, we don't agree with the prophet. Stop there. We don't agree with the prophet. He cannot lie. We agree with the prophet as sinful.
Okay. The book of Deuteronomy in chapter 20, I believe it says, 18. Didn't he say that the one who speaks from himself is implying
if you prophesy a false prophecy,
and which doesn't come true, is a false prophet. That's what I'm saying.
Okay. Yeah, but he's not a prophet of God.
So the true prophet would not give a false prophecy.
Okay, in that sense.
Yeah, yeah. So if I show you something through your Bible that Jesus gave a false prophecy, I'd like you to answer me.
Jesus gave a false prophecy.
Yes, according, but it was Jesus who was speaking. Okay, can we read Mark? Mark. Is it Mark? Sorry. Let's go to Matthew.
So all of this, this is what you come up with.
You come up with a lot of foolish things all the time. But
so tell me one foolish thing. No. One foolish thing we said.
I'll tell you after that. I will.
I will, really.
You have to.
Sperm comes from the black hole. That's one foolish thing.
That's a foolish thing.
That's why CP didn't make
it. Did I? I'm changing the argument right now. But I'm telling you one foolish thing. This is a good question. This is not foolish, I'm saying. This is a good question. So I'm saying foolish. I will tell you what foolish.
Okay, Matthew chapter.
I will tell you.
Matthew chapter 16, verse 20. Matthew chapter 17 verse 15.
16 verse 28.
16 verse 28.
Let me read it. Truly.
Okay.
Truly I say to you, there are some standing here who will not taste death before they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. Yes? Kingdom of God. Is that right? Now, the kingdom of God has not arrived yet.
Who says that?
Your book says that.
No, that's a lie.
Book of Revelation. Book of Revelation says that. I'm going to read it to you.
Wait, hold on. Before you go to the book of Revelation.
Ask a question, let us respond, and then to refute us.
So you say, who says that? I'm telling you who says that. But I'm telling you book of Revelation says that.
So the book of Revelation, that come prior to the book of Romans.
Huh?
That come prior to the books Paul wrote. All the books that Paul wrote, from the Corinthians, Ephesians, Galatians, and Romans, all these books he wrote.
Let me read what book of Revelation says that, then we see where there is a right and where is wrong, Let me
But that wasn't a false prophecy.
That was
not
a false prophecy. So what's your point?
What is your
Jesus
point?
Jesus saying it, those people, stop characterizing me all the time. This is not. Let's deal with the question. Stop characterizing me. You do all the time. You got bad.
I feel sorry for you. I'm sorry for you. You don't have a hoodie. You're gonna get cold. You're gonna have cold tomorrow. Anyway, go on.
Beautiful. What he says? I feel sorry for you. Jesus says, if somebody asks you a coat, give him a jacket. Can I have your jacket?
No.
He's not a disciple of Jesus.
Jesus said, don't push me off the
cliff. Jesus says, somebody asked you a jacket, give him a cloak. I'm asking you, I am getting wet, can I have your jacket?
How is that?
I know you're not going to take it, but
can I have? I like the red color, actually.
Okay. Okay. You go. No. Anyway, let's get back to the point.
You see, they're not very Christian.
This is why we always say he doesn't see CP. Because he makes this claim, and then we say, he's going to shit your claim, and he starts waffling about jackets and
all this stuff about the weather and about. How is that false prophecy?
Okay. Jesus is saying here, he's talking to his disciples. Until the kingdom of God come, some of you will still be alive. Now we know, unless you tell me there's some of disciple hiding somewhere in the cave in Jerusalem, that's another matter. I don't know if you can prove that. But we know all the disciples have died and kingdom of God has not arrived yet, according to John, book of Revelation, chapter 12, verse 10.
Okay, that's a lie.
Let me read. Now I'm making my case here, isn't it? I'm saying that I'm going to tell you about my understanding.
Man, today is not nice.
Yeah, I'm going to be going soon. Okay, now here, what John says in book of Revelation, chapter 12, verse 10. He says, and I heard a loud voice saying in heaven. Now he's talking about the end of days. If you read the whole context. And he says, saying in heaven, now is come salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ, for the accuser of our brethren in cast down, which accused them before our God day and night. This is verse 10. The whole context is saying end of the days when Jesus will come back. That is the kingdom of God when he comes, when he's going to come back in his second coming. According to John, that is the kingdom of God. So we need to know, kingdom of God has not arrived yet. And Jesus says until kingdom of God will arrive, one of you who's standing here will still be alive. So I want to know, unless you prove to me any of his disciples is still alive, if they are not, the Jesus prophecy is proven false. So according to that, either Jesus is a false prophet or either your Bible is not inspired word of God.
Okay, I'm going to respond and then he will respond as well. Is that okay with you?
No problem.
Okay.
No problem. You can bring Trinity, bring another one.
No. Don't worry, we don't need that. So you quote
Trinity Matthew, against unity.
You quoted Matthew 16:28 to prove that the kingdom of God is not here yet. Jesus Christ is a liar, yeah?
Jesus according Christ, to the Bible, yeah. But we believe he's not
Jesus
a liar.
Christ,
he's not a liar.
Jesus Christ, yeah, was talking about the kingdom of God, yeah, and that this was pre-resurrection, yeah, pre-resurrection, before he resurrected.
Of course, yeah.
So after he resurrected, he breathed into his disciples, and he told them, "Have the Holy Spirit, receive the Holy Spirit." So they have the Holy Spirit. So the kingdom of God is here on earth within the believers. Yeah.
Can you prove?
That's why he said in Luke chapter 17, verse 20-22, he said the kingdom of God is within you. The kingdom of God is within you.
Okay.
Yeah?
Okay.
The only way the kingdom of God is within them is because of the Holy Spirit. So the physical coming, physical part will come at the end. However, the part that he's talking about, no one will taste death until they see the kingdom of God coming. That was the actual Holy Spirit coming into them in Acts chapter 1 as well, Luke chapter 17, and I believe Matthew 28. But he was talking about that kingdom. So the final kingdom, when he's coming literally, physically, that one, that wasn't what he was referring to.
Okay.
Yeah? So they're not going to taste death until he comes, because they were still alive when he resurrected from the dead. You quoted Matthew, which was pre-resurrection. So post-resurrection is what he was referring to. Not when he's coming back.
I will come back and reply that.
I
heard you.
Can elaborate more.
So there's a false misconception, misunderstanding that there is this physical kingdom and that was propagated from different people. But the actual kingdom is a spiritual kingdom, which Daniel was speaking about, which is the spirit of God inside of us, the kingdom that lives inside of us. Okay, and not only do we have it now in this physical world or in earth, but also take it into the afterlife with us. So it's a kingdom that lasts forever. But that's why in the Book of Romans, didn't read through Romans chapter 14. Let me see if I've got it here. Verse 17 says, "For the kingdom of God is not eating and drinking, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit." So it's the Spirit of God
in the Holy Spirit.
That's in the Holy Spirit, right? So it's the kingdom of God, it's the spiritual presence of God inside of the believer that Jesus was speaking about. And so many of the disciples, many of the apostles, they had this Holy Spirit. That's why when you read the book of Acts, it's through the power of the Spirit of God they preached and proclaimed the gospel and the good news and the truth. Okay? And so there's this misconception that it's this, some kingdom theology. No, it's not. It's the Spirit of God inside of your heart, and it continues on for eternity.
Just can I elaborate something? One more, just elaborate.
Okay.
He answered them, Luke 17, verse 20 to 21. I'm going to read two verses and then you can respond. Yeah? The coming of the kingdom. Yeah? Being asked by the Pharisees when the kingdom of God will come, they asked him. He answered them, the kingdom of God is not coming with something observable. This is Jesus saying, yeah? No one will say, look here. Or there, for you see, the kingdom of God is among you. Yeah, pre-resurrection. After the resurrection, we read in Acts chapter 1 verse 8 that the Holy Spirit came down on them, and Acts chapter 2 verse 2 to 4 as well. He came down. Luke chapter 17 verse 20 to 21.
And he says, the kingdom is gone, is among you. So he's talking to them, and meaning kingdom of God is there with them. But that contradicts with Matthew 16:28, because he said one of you will still be alive when the kingdom of God will come.
Yes.
So if according to Luke, kingdom of God is already there, why he says it's going to come?
Because it wasn't in them. It's among them.
Yeah. So he's
not in them. It wasn't in them.
Yeah. So he wasn't.
It was among them.
So the presence of God was there. The presence of God was there.
Okay.
And so what we're saying is that in the book of Acts chapter 1, then the Spirit of God entered inside of them. So every believer, that's why we speak about the church.
Okay. Can I say something? I heard
the kingdom of God.
My problem is here is that when John writing Revelation,
that's the physical kingdom.
No. So he's talking about the kingdom
literally when
in the physical, future.
When
yes.
Mean kingdom,
present,
kingdom
and future.
So you mean kingdom with power?
Is when he actually comes back physically.
The physical. What's the difference between the physical kingdom and the spiritual kingdom? What's the difference?
No. You just answered the question.
No.
One is spiritual, one is physical.
No. What is the power? The kingdom with power. What is that?
Literally, when Jesus Christ comes back physically, all hell will break loose. All evil will die. It will be completely wiped out.
I know. So that is the kingdom.
So that is him taking the actual territory.
No, you're not understanding my question. I said, is that
is
the kingdom with power? Is that right? That the kingdom will come in the end? Is that one? Let me make my point. Is that is the kingdom with power? That's why I'm asking you a question. The one coming in the end, is that a kingdom with the power?
So the physical and the spiritual together. Yeah.
So both the spiritual and both the physical have power.
Okay.
The Holy Spirit gives power. That's why you read it. That's why you read in the Bible. It says that the power.
Can you prove from the Bible that the both are with the power?
Yeah, the power of the Holy Spirit. Yes.
Sorry.
The Holy Spirit.
Bring any question. Bring any question. Christian Prince, refute me. You guys are keep bringing that. I'm challenging you, all of you together. Bring any one question with Christian Prince argument. Bring here, which he refuted me.
I did, but I don't want to deviate. So the spiritual kingdom.
We can talk about it. Brother Jacob, anytime bring it. We can.
Yeah,
because
I like
he,
you. You're a nice guy. You're amicable. So, but don't call Christian Prince
but
anymore.
But you know,
it's not good for your image.
No. I don't care about my image. I care about the truth. I care about the truth.
Yeah,
and I believe he's a liar and he's a deceiver.
He's not a liar.
He's
a scholar of Islam. You're not a scholar.
There are Muslim scholars as well. So what? Scholars can be right. Scholars can be wrong. That doesn't mean scholars.
The Holy Spirit being in them, that is power.
Point I'm making
that
here,
is power.
Which you are kind of playing around with it. The kingdom of God, which will come in the end, that is the kingdom with power. Kingdom of God with power. Not the one with the spiritual one. That is what he's talking about. The kingdom with power.
In the book of John, chapter 14, verse 12, Jesus said, "You will do greater works than I did." That is power. Because the Holy Spirit will be in them.
Oh, no, no, let me
by the power
again.
Of the Holy Spirit, so, you will do
so in the okay, book of, in the, hold on one second, because you're talking about power. In the book of Acts, chapter 1, verse 8, that is important. But you will receive what? Power. When the Holy Spirit has come upon you.
Power.
And you shall be my witnesses both in Jerusalem, and Judea, amen. And Samaria, and amen. Even to the remote parts of the earth. So, both kingdoms have power. See what I'm saying?
It's power. Is that word is saying kingdom of power?
Is it the Holy Spirit?
The Holy Spirit is the kingdom.
The Holy Spirit is the kingdom.
Yes.
He brings the power.
No, you say Holy Spirit. Are you playing with the words here now?
Yes.
Holy, okay. The Holy show me the words and I agree with you. It says the Holy Spirit is the kingdom. Don't play with the words.
No, I'm not playing with the words. When Jesus said, in Matthew 16:28, you will not taste death until you see the kingdom of God coming.
That's right.
Yeah? That's what he's talking about.
No, you have to show me if the Holy Spirit comes. The Holy Spirit is actually the kingdom of God.
He gives them the power.
Guys, I'll repeat, I'll read it again to you. Listen very carefully, Abbas.
What are you reading?
Okay, Romans 4 and 17. I just read it to you. You didn't listen. There's a problem. You do this on CPO a lot.
He says something else.
Listen again.
Stop bringing CPO all the time. What's wrong with you?
You asked the question, yes, about the kingdom.
What's the matter with you guys? Characterizing.
So, this kingdom of God is not... What is the kingdom of God? It is not eating. It is not drinking. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. It's the Holy Spirit. That is the joy, the Holy Spirit that brings to your life. That is the kingdom of God. And we've said this to you over and again. You keep doing it. You're just not listening.
Okay, no, great.
Jesus never made a
false
prophecy.
Let's make it clear. You've been refuted on that, so don't ever bring that up again, yes?
Well, let's move on to the next one.
Let's ask a question now. We do one question. Question for question.
Okay.
So why is it that you pray to why is it that
same question?
No, about Muhammad. Why do you pray to a dead man?
You didn't answer. Oh, I didn't hear your answer.
Okay. I pray to a dead man. Can you quote to me something that as a Muslim I pray to a dead man?
No problem.
I pray to a dead man. Remember I prayed
Sahih Bukhari.
I thought you said Tashahud, you're gonna say.
Yeah, that's the question. So we want to know.
Okay.
So you make your prayers every
five
times a day, right?
That's right. Yeah.
Okay. And so when you make these prayers, you pray to Muhammad, right?
No, we don't. We pray to Allah.
Okay. You pray to Allah. Okay,
so while you're praying to Allah,
that's right. Yeah, you correct your terminology words. Right. You don't pray to Muhammad.
He said it right, but we're gonna prove it.
He said it wrong.
We're gonna prove it.
Because remember, my claim is that you pray to a dead man. Say you don't. Let's go.
So while you're doing,
I'm telling you, I do not pray to a dead man.
Okay.
I pray to Allah.
Can we read your tashahhud?
Please. Yes.
In your prayers to Allah, this is what you say in your tashahhud. All compliments, prayers, and good things are due to Allah. Peace be upon you, O Prophet. And Allah's mercy and blessings be upon you. When you're saying that, who are you talking to?
Now you say you pray to Muhammad. Where did it say I pray to Muhammad?
I just read, it says, peace be. This is in your prayers. This is already in your prayers. This is while you're praying to Allah. While you're praying to Allah, you're communicating with Muhammad. Yes. By saying
that's a better terminology. Communicating with
what is prayer?
Not praying to Muhammad.
What is prayer? Communicating.
I am praying to Allah. In that prayer, I am sending peace of Allah to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's another question.
While you are praying,
you're not letting me
clear. No, Abbas.
When you ask a question, give me a chance.
I want it to be clear for you.
Let it be clear.
This is why,
since I'm here,
Abbas, listen.
Attack on my character all the time.
Give me
this is not fair. You're not answering, you're dodging. Stop doing that. It doesn't suit you, it's not nice.
Just give me 20 seconds. Give me 20 seconds. While you're praying to Allah, you're communicating with a dead man.
The prostate.
That's called shirk. Why do you do that?
Okay.
Can he hear your
prayer? Can you read the full tashahud? Can you complete the tashahud? In English? I don't remember in English.
I just read it.
No, no, you didn't finish it. Can you complete the whole tashahud?
Listen, whether I complete it or not,
it's no, no, it's important.
Right in the middle, it's important to Muhammad.
It's important. Why would you deny that?
All prayers, yeah. All compliments and prayers and good things are due to Allah. Mm. Peace be upon you, O Prophet, and Allah's mercy and blessings be upon you. Peace be upon us and on the true pious.
No, that's it. Peace and
that's what I'm saying. Mercy, I didn't need to go on.
Mercy of Allah be upon you in the end.
Upon you, yeah.
Yeah, mercy of Allah. Okay. Now, one thing we understand, I think you're trying to imply here that we're doing shirk. You said that actually. You said that we're doing shirk. No, no, you're saying it. The shirk mean worshipping somebody other than Allah. But in that tashahud, you heard that we are saying mercy of Allah be upon you. So what kind of a worship we doing to a man when we asking that we want Allah's mercy be upon you? So it's clear that he can't interfere. Let me speak. You have to hear me out.
Go on.
It's important.
I thought you finished.
No, I haven't finished. So if we are worshipping a deity, what kind of a deity we are worshipping that we are saying mercy of somebody else be upon you? So that is clear that we are not worshipping him. What we saying we want, we are praying for him that Allah's blessing and mercy and peace be upon you. So that is clear we are not worshipping. So don't use the word shirk.
So while you're saying peace be upon you,
yeah,
and may Allah's blessing be upon you,
yeah.
You're not asking Allah at that time.
Okay.
You're saying may Allah's blessings and peace be upon you. So you're speaking directly to him.
Good question.
Yeah.
Can I answer it?
You can answer it. And by the way, you do not say these things to Jesus, Abraham, and everyone. It's only Muhammad.
Did I claim that I say that?
No. In your tashahud.
Did I claim?
I'm not talking about you.
Okay.
In your tashahud, it's only to Muhammad.
Subhanallah.
Okay. So
Allahu Akbar Kabira.
Deal with that.
Alhamdulillah Kaseera.
Did you watch?
Subhanallah Bukratum Wasila.
Did you watch the Islamic Valentine?
Huh?
You watched the Islamic Valentine?
Yes, I did.
Did I say Subhanallah correctly?
Yeah, very nice. You were saying, oh, Islamophobes, Islamophobes. That's a beautiful, yeah. I think there should be a second one as well.
It's coming.
It's a good one. Yeah, you guys have a talent, man. I'm telling you, good acting.
Okay. So I'll respond.
Now, the answer is that you don't say to Jesus or anything, but do you know that very words we saying to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, peace be upon you.
You are saying it to him. I just want to clarify. You are saying it to Muhammad.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so he can hear you.
Yeah, I'll answer that. That's the second question. But
no,
I say,
okay.
I will answer one by one. How he can hear us? Yes. The thing is, when we say to you, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, peace be upon you and Allah's mercy, you know what we're doing? We are obeying our Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who says in the Quran, which you always quote here, Allah's and His angels' praise be on Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and who you believe, send your peace and blessings or prayers to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So in that prayer, in the salah, we are actually following the command of our Lord. Following the command of our Lord is the worship, and by following His command, we are sending to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam peace and blessings of Allah be upon you. That's one side. Now the question is, can he hear us? Yes. Well, how he can hear us? Well, I think there's a hadith here. I think you were talking to Hijab earlier on, that Allah's angels takes it to the prophets. Yeah. So this is their job. So when we say to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, why we say that? Because Allah said that to us. So we say it, saying to him direct, but the angels will take what we said. Abbas have said this for you. Inshallah, one day God will say that for you. One day.
Never.
So this is how, if you say how can he hear us? We do not believe he hears us directly at that moment in time, but that message will go to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Abbas have said that to you directly. So this is what we believe. This is how he heard. Does that answer your question?
So do you see why we call it shirk? The reason why we call it shirk is because what you have been doing is you're giving the attributes, which is one of them being omniscience, okay, of being able to know things, omnipresent, you have to be all powerful, I'm saying. So you're giving this to Muhammad, which only belongs to God, because only God can hear millions of possible over a billion prayers at the same time. And so, even if it was, think about how many Muslims are praying at the same time, peace and Mecca.
Yeah.
So all these prayers are coming to Muhammad. that he's a mere man who died. Now the reason why we know Shirk and why you're putting Muhammad on the same level of deity as Allah is because you've given his divine attributes over to him. Did you not see that?
Yeah, can I answer that? Now you say,
I've got a question.
You say, you see, you are making him like omnipresent, yeah?
Or omniscient.
All knowing, omniscient. Okay, now the meaning of omniscient is when in every moment in time, the God who's omniscient, he knows everything at the same time. Everything. Now we are not making that claim about Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. We're saying when we pray to him, we're not saying, and this very, you see,
yeah, he prays to dead Muhammad. He says he's already admitted.
So I said, you see what happened? You see what happened now?
No, but you know,
you see, one, my wish comes true. And I say, you say one or two, I say, make a trinity of it. Yeah? So Trinity, one, two, three, Trinity against the unity, Alhamdulillah. So, my wish comes true. So, you told me the manners. When somebody's speaking, do not interfere. You just say that about the manner. I'm sorry, I have to answer his question first. Can I say your favorite phrase? Get in line, yeah? So, yeah, okay, no problem.
I'm asking you this question, please.
Hold your horses.
That's all fine. I just wanted to understand what you said. So as I listen, I am following the conversation. So you confirm that you pray to Muhammad.
It's on the video. We had a talk for 25 minutes.
So
remember
you said yes.
I said yes.
Okay.
You forgot. You have a bad memory.
So you are okay.
They pray to Muhammad.
That's fine. So
Martin, you already forgot.
Okay. Now.
We had a debate 25 minutes, and I said we shook hands. I said yes.
I disagree with you.
I'll wash after. I'll wash my hands after.
You wash your hands with the earth or with the water?
So you disobey Allah, you pray to Muhammad.
Actually, I do ghusl. I do ghusl.
What are you doing this?
I actually do ghusl. Can I answer? Look, my brothers, they want to learn about Islam. Maybe one day become Muslim. Let me tell them.
But just before you answer, I just want you to answer. I just want to say, do you not see how that would be a major issue for us if I was to say I prayed to Moses or I prayed to Elijah or I prayed to
Mary.
I think we are diverting
because I need to answer the omniscient thing. Yeah,
and that was both our questions.
I already answered your question. We pray to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in our salah. Why? Because our Allah has. You know, listen. I'm answering your question now first. We pray not to Moses or anybody. You don't, because our Lord in the Quran chapter 33 verse 56 tell us to pray to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So in the salah,
Allah prays.
I am a Muslim. I'm not afraid of it.
So you're following.
I'll answer that question as well.
Yeah, I agree with you, but Allah says,
we are praying to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam because Allah told us in the Quran. Allah didn't tell us in the Quran to pray to Moses or Jesus. So that's one question. Your question was, is Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam omniscient like God that he can hear everything when billions of Muslims are praying? So my answer to you is, who is saying when are we praying billions of Muslims? At this moment in time, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is hearing us. Nobody's claiming that. We say angels take our prayers. And take it to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. In what time and when they're going to take it to him, Allahu Alam, we don't know. Whenever he's going to receive. We're not saying
it doesn't matter, he receives it.
So Muhammad is responding to the prayer.
When he will receive the prayer.
It doesn't matter, he receives it.
When he receives the prayer, then he will answer. And we know that dead people are living in a different dimension. Yes? This is a different dimension. It's not same like,
no,
they're like our time and their time is the same time. It's not that. It's a different dimension. Now I'm forgetting
so
about
dead
it.
Deadpan can hear your prayer.
You know why you're wrong, Abbas? Let me read why you're wrong, okay? Because he speaks about mirrors. Okay, so there's Abu Huraira reported. The messenger of Allah said, whenever someone greets me, so saying,
whenever,
Allah returns the soul to my body in the grave, and I return his greetings. So whenever they do it, yes?
So whenever you go to Hajj, yes? Millions of them, then you greet him in the Hajj, millions of them, yes. Muhammad is returning them as millions of them, whenever.
Because Allah sends his soul back to his body.
If you're praying here in this corner or in your mosque, whatever.
Misunderstanding. Whenever I do it, Allah in reaction to that, he will bring Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam into that and he will return.
He brings his soul.
It says whenever you do it.
Yeah. Whenever you do it, you will get the response of that.
Yes? So it can be anytime. It can be now, right now.
It's not
right now. Muhammad can respond to that.
Whenever I do it, Allah will bring Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam back into his body.
He will come back into his body.
Yeah. Well, that's why I know it's hadith, but this hadith does not correlate what we tashahhud we're talking about. Tashahhud we're talking about is not the same thing we're talking about here.
So this has nothing to do with the tashahhud. Is that what you're saying?
Tashahhud, yes,
it's correct.
Tashahhud is not the same.
Muhammad is responding to your salam whenever you do. Let's say Friday prayer.
Word for word. It's very important. If you're going to bring a fabricated hadith, I'm not obliged to answer that one.
There are no fabricated hadiths.
What do you mean no fabricated?
There are either Sahih hadiths, Hassan hadith, or Da'if.
So you don't know this fabrication. Do you know Maudu? What Maudu calls?
Okay, yeah, Maudu's fabrication, but we're not talking about that.
So don't say there is no fabricated hadith.
Yeah.
But we're not talking about that. He said there is no. But I'm saying there are.
But we are not talking about that.
So what hadith is that?
If that hadith is fabricated, give us the reason.
What do you mean?
If
there is a weak hadith, what reference will satisfy you if that I would not follow weak hadith? What reference you?
Yeah, the one you claim, like chain of narration, all that madness you guys.
No. What you want me to show you that weak hadith?
It breaks. There's no chain anymore. So it's a daif. Show us that.
Guys, you are giving him opportunity.
Grace upon grace.
But he still hasn't dealt with the issue. Muhammad, Allah does send Muhammad's soul.
It's gotta be tough love on you.
And his body is able to respond whenever.
One thing we agree that Muhammad is not omniscient. Why?
If he's not omniscient, he's a respondent.
One thing is clear, because omniscient, the very meaning of omniscient is you do not need any external help. You just understand everything in this moment, that moment in time. But since Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam need guide, help of Allah to heard our prayer, that tells that he is not omniscient. Allah is bringing his soul back for us to understand. He's not understanding by himself. Do you get my point?
Allah has given him his own
attributes. So he's not.
Allah has given him his own attributes.
He belongs to Allah. Abbas. How come? If Allah is giving me all his attributes, then Muhammad doesn't need Allah's help. He will just
That's what you're saying.
This is your sources, yes?
Your sources is saying that this soul is coming back, yes?
Yeah.
So Allah is bringing his soul back. So what Allah is doing, okay, because in God's nature, in his very nature, he's omniscient, he's omnipotent, yes? Right? So in his very nature, he did things. He cannot give it to someone else. He cannot make you omniscient, okay? Unless he's making you God, okay?
He's not making you omniscient.
Right, but he's bringing him back, and he's able to receive all these prayers, all these peace, all these salams, all these things.
How? How?
That's what I'm asking.
No.
Whenever.
No. That's something. But I'm telling you.
I know it's nice, it's alright for you to laugh and just try to make a mockery of it.
But
if you, no. If
just answer the question.
If you are sincere, then you need to hear me out rather than just trying to mock. You need to read the other hadith. Other hadith tells us.
Let's read some of the other hadith.
Brother, let me make my point. Other hadith says the angels will take the prayers of people to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Meaning. He need assistance of angels to hurt us.
No
so he cannot be omniscient if he need help of angels.
Okay.
That's by the by. I have clarified this that he is not omniscient. Okay. Now,
so
no, God is making him omniscient.
Abu Huraira reported the messenger of Allah said, "Do not make my grave a place of festivity, and supplicate Allah for me, for your supplications reaches me wherever you are."
How it reaches him?
So
how it reaches him?
Right. It's what it says here is that wherever you are,
your supplication will reach you.
So that's what I'm asking you.
So no.
I'm saying, unless he has the attribute,
then
that Allah has
then
given
you
him,
need to understand the complete scriptures. And the other hadith says that, which was you quoted to Muhammad Hijab earlier, the angels will take the prayers to him. So in the whole context, we understand how it reaches, the angels will take to him. So if angels take to him, so don't say that he's omniscient. He's not omniscient.
He is. Allah has given him that.
My next
question is,
yes.
Why don't you do this with the other prophets? Why only Muhammad?
Isn't that my question now?
I was going to ask you a question.
Why we don't do to Moses?
Why don't you do with any other prophet?
That's a very good question. I think already answered, but you didn't pay attention. I said,
Allah, why only Muhammad?
I'm answering. I already answered actually earlier. Yes, I did. I said, because Allah commanded us in the Quran to do about Muhammad. Allah, if Allah would have commanded us to do about Moses or Jesus, we would have done that as well. Because Allah didn't
what
command
makes
us.
Muhammad
but
so special?
Muhammad.
Why is it just Muhammad?
Yes. Muhammad has done also told
all the prophets equal?
Yeah, are they not equal? Because look, here, look.
Or is it just Muhammad being the God of Islam?
Okay, yeah. Okay, that's a good question. They are equal, but they are not identical in their qualities as well. Some have different qualities. Like Muhammad didn't
that's
give anybody a life. Muhammad didn't give
this got nothing to
Muhammad
do with their qualities.
Muhammad didn't split the sea. Moses did.
Okay,
Muhammad didn't bring anybody
that.
To life.
That's
so
fine.
Jesus did. So they are not identical in things.
They're different, but equal. That's what you're saying.
Because we're going here. Yeah, we're there to your sources, Abbas. This is the thing. We always bring you your sources, but you never bring
us. Yeah, you're bringing sources.
So let's
so
read this about the other prophets.
I'm not denying your sources.
About other
I'm answering your sources.
Aus reported. The Messenger of Allah said, among the best of your days is Friday. So supplicate Allah
that's the hadith
more
I was talking
often
about.
For me in it.
Angels
for your supplications
it.
Will be displayed to me.
Display.
He was asked, O Messenger of Allah, how will our blessings be displayed to you when your decayed body will have been mixed with earth? He replied, Allah has prohibited the earth from consuming the bodies of the prophets. So why is it, if all the prophets, their bodies are not consumed, why just Muhammad?
I answered you already, you know, listen to me.
You didn't answer it.
I say, because Allah says in the Quran, O you believers, like Allah and angels send prayers to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Why
O you believers, send your prayers to Muhammad. Why ask Allah why Muhammad? Allah told us about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
No.
This is the answer to your question.
It's about Muhammad. We follow the command of Allah.
He received
Allah.
He received the revelation.
Allah is the guinea pig.
That is your opinion. That's your opinion.
That's what
I have given you answer.
That's what the Quran
we do
says.
It.
That's what the
we
says.
Do it because Allah commanded us.
No.
As a true follower of God, you must follow the command of God. Since God does not command about Muhammad, Moses and Jesus, but hear me out. When I say Moses, I say Allah has salam. We are supposed to say mercy be upon him. So actually I'm saying about Moses, mercy be upon him, but not in our salah. So we also say peace to Moses.
Okay, so
Abbas, can I get into your mind a little bit?
Yeah, go on.
Listen to what I'm saying.
I'm an open book, bro.
Isn't it ironic?
Question taking 20 minutes, my question took 5 minutes.
One second. Isn't it just ironic that the fact that Muhammad received this revelation from Allah, there was no witnesses, yes? So for him to receive this revelation, yes? And all these revelations and all these things that's about Muhammad all seem to make him
this
divine.
You're going somewhere else now. This is another question.
But this is the point.
I answered your question. Now it's turned from my question now. No, you're going by the theology.
No, you asked the question, we answered it.
This is No, I didn't. What question I asked?
Matthew chapter 16.
Yeah, but then you asked me this question now. But now you're going to theology.
No,
This is definitely a different question.
I'm trying to get to see how convenient this is, yes? Because our claim here is that Muhammad is basically essentially deity. Or his claim is the God of Islam. That's what our claim is. Yeah. But ask me these questions about prayer. That's our point. We're saying that you pray to no other apart from God. You've admitted that you pray to Muhammad. And what we're saying is that if you pray to Muhammad, prayer only belongs to God. And so what I'm saying to you...
I have to stop you here. Hold on. I already told you we do not pray to Muhammad. I told you already.
That's what you do. So
stop saying that we pray to Muhammad. Abbas. We pray to Allah in that prayer, we compliment Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
And you speak to a dead man.
Yes, so don't say we pray. No problem, don't say we pray to Muhammad.
But the reason why he's saying you pray to Muhammad is because
we do not pray.
This is within your prayers to Allah. Okay. So what do you call
is it a prayer?
Wait, hang on.
Is it a prayer to you? No. Stop.
No, he's saying calm down.
Let's calm down.
He's telling me
because I have
down.
To talk over him.
I'm calm.
Okay. When I say to you, yeah. Daniel, may God be mercy on you. Am I praying to you?
He's standing in front of
you. No, actually, I'm praying for you.
I'm right in front of you.
No, but I'm not dead. Even if you are dead.
I'm alive.
Look,
you can feel me.
Daniel.
I can hear you.
No problem. Daniel, even if you are dead.
So you can talk to Daniel when he's dead. Go on.
Stop playing with words.
Go on. Finish your sentence.
This is not
finish your sentence. He said, even if you're dead.
You are not letting me finish.
Okay, go on.
Let me finish. Then you say, even if you're dead, and I said to you, yeah, that, oh, Daniel, pray be on you.
Sorry?
No.
Daniel, what?
I say if.
Daniel, what?
Daniel, may Allah be Allah's mercy be on you. If I say that, am I praying to you or praying for you?
No, I'm praying for you.
I'm praying for you.
Praying to him.
No, I'm not praying to him. No.
Okay, can I respond?
Pray to him is like this. No. Pray to him is like this. No. Prayer.
No. God have mercy on you.
I think you have a misunderstanding of praying too.
Peace be upon Daniel. But not peace be upon
you. You see why I'm raising my voice? Because either he talk, I have to talk over.
No, praying
to his son. Again, characterizing me.
No, but what we're saying is the logical process.
The logical process.
If you're not praying to me while I'm dead, you wouldn't say the word you.
Okay, let me.
You would say Allah. May your blessings be upon Daniel. That's it.
I think there is a...
But when you're saying, may the blessings of Allah be upon you, you're speaking to me.
I think there's a big...
Or you're speaking to Muhammad.
No. I think there's a big barrier among us to understand what praying to means and what praying for means. Let me explain. According to Muslims, praying to is like this. Oh, Daniel, please help me. This is praying to that you can help
not
me.
Only
but
that.
No. But when I say, oh Daniel, may God be mercy on you, that according to Islam is not praying to, is praying for you to God. That's the difference there.
So because if you're praying for me, wait, Abbas, let me respond to that. If you're praying for me to God, this is what you would say. Allah, may your blessings be upon Daniel.
No.
Then you're praying for me. Yes. To God. But if you're praying to me, you will say, may Allah's blessings be upon you.
I think there's a misunderstanding on your part. No, it's not.
Roger Federer, I'm joking.
Look, if you guys here to win, I want you to win and you win and I lose. I am not here to defeat.
We're here to show you the truth.
I think you know me long enough. I've been coming here. I am not here. Seriously, let me clarify this. I don't come here to defeat people. But wallahi, I come to win over people rather than defeat. But if you want to defeat me, good luck to you. You win all the time.
We're not here to defeat.
You say game, set, and match. What that means?
Yeah, but that's just a saying.
Game, set, and match. What is it? You lose? What is it?
That's just a saying.
No.
That's just a saying.
Come on, that means you mean I.
No problem. It's just emotions. Jokes and
sense. Why don't you become my personal psychiatrist?
No, stop being
so sensitive. You emotional, you CP.
We've seen a joke.
Okay, now.
Become a psychiatrist.
No, that would be the logical.
You know why? I'll tell you.
Do you understand what I said? That would be the logical process. Not to me.
In Islam.
Allah's blessing to
me. In Islam. In Islam, praying true meaning when we are asking for help. In Islam, that's what I'm saying. Muslim understanding.
According to who?
No, Muslim understanding.
I don't care about Muslim understanding.
Muslim understanding.
Where in Islamic
Muslim
tradition?
Understanding
and
is,
also references.
Muslim understanding is when we pray to, meaning we asking for help.
Okay.
But we are asking for somebody.
Okay. Do you know what? Let's just clear this up. Give us a reference.
Okay. Yeah, I know. You're gonna say that.
Okay. Because
you're saying Muslim understanding.
You're making all this
Muslim
understanding.
Okay.
Muslim understanding.
If I give you a reference. Okay.
Yes,
that
makes that point.
I am not an encyclopedia of Islam and all that, but I can promise you. I can.
You got a substantiate.
No. In talk, this thing comes up. But I thought this is.
You can bring it next week. You don't have it today. Is that what you're saying?
This is yes. Yeah, I will bring next week. No problem.
Okay.
This is such a common knowledge in Islam that we believe when you're asking somebody to help you, especially when that person is dead, that is a prayer, and we're not allowed to do to anybody else. And that's what we call shirk.
Okay. And then this prayer that you're praying in your tashahud, communicating with Muhammad, that in a Muslim understanding is not praying to Muhammad.
No,
absolutely. So we need references.
Yeah, we references from Islamic tradition.
No, that's what you claim. You're trying to make a very small box.
No, I didn't say that.
You didn't hit me up. I say in Islamic terminology, Islamic understanding, when you're asking somebody to help you, that is praying too. I didn't say in that tashahud, that the meaning of the tashahud is we are not praying to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. I'm saying in general, when you're asking somebody to help, in general, Muslims, when we're asking somebody to help, that is praying too. But we're asking help for somebody, even if he's present or not, that's not praying too. That's praying for.
Yeah, if you pray for someone, that's fine. What we're saying is this, that you are, it states that you, Muhammad, so you're directly addressing Muhammad.
Yes.
Okay? So we're speaking about the word you. Now you're saying in Islamic traditional, Islamic culture, however, that no, if you address someone by saying you could actually be praying for them, not actually to them. So we want that reference from you.
Okay. That very tashahud actually is telling us that we're praying for him, even though addressing him, but we're praying for him. We say, Allah's mercy be upon you, O Prophet.
Abbas, just so say you don't have the reference. Just say you don't have, don't use that as a excuse.
What reference?
We're saying to you that if I say to you, Abbas, I say, peace be upon you. Am I speaking to Daniel?
Nobody saying we're not speaking to him, but you misunderstand.
Since we are speaking to him,
right. That doesn't mean we are praying to him.
Now, if I was to say...
There's a difference here.
Now, if I was to say... Okay, it doesn't make any sense. But if I was to say...
I know it doesn't make sense to you.
If I was to be praying, say I was just praying, show me here praying, and then as I was praying, you heard me say something like, peace be upon you, Daniel. Okay, while I was praying, okay, and you know I'm praying, would you think that I'm addressing Daniel or not?
I'm not saying we are not addressing Muhammad.
So when you're addressing Muhammad,
but we are addressing,
so if you're addressing Muhammad, then that, you are praying
No. When we are,
how can you not get this?
When we are addressing
so
Muhammad,
clear,
Muhammad
when, it's like, no, when it's we like are, it's as clear as water.
When we are addressing him, in that address we are saying, Allah's mercy be upon you. We are not saying, oh Muhammad, send your mercy to us, or ask Allah to mercy. That will
saying.
Be praying to
him. Do you know what? We kind of beat this to death. It's like a dead horse. We just keep beating
you. You are.
But we need that reference next week. Yeah?
Reference of what?
What are you doing for?
Let's clarify. Reference of what? No, I want to clarify in words. Right, what reference you want?
So what we want is, you said that in Islamic culture tradition, you could make that statement, but you in terms of directing someone, addressing someone directly, however, you could actually be praying for them.
No.
That's
what you said, yeah.
No.
I said in Islamic terminology.
When you're saying someone who's dead, help me, that means you're praying to them.
We know that.
When we are asking help
from somebody, especially when they are dead,
that's prayer.
That means prayer, yeah?
Okay, but that's not what we're asking.
But when we are asking mercy for somebody of Allah, that is not praying to.
Okay, can you show us a reference?
As I say. No, I'll bring
it. Okay, so there's your homework for next week? Yes? Thank you.
Sorry, I don't need a homework from anybody, man. Seriously.
No, but
I'm going to help you out. I'm going to help you out on that. So, okay. So one question. You see that my question took 5-10 minutes.
We just concluded.
Yes.
One question is one question. We're going to be debating next week, yes?
No problem. Okay.
No homework for them.
Well, homework for you is just pray to Allah to guide you, What's the channel called?
What's the channel? Is it some of it?
Okay. Thank you.
Abbas has concluded. He has admitted that they do pray. That Muhammad can hear their prayers, the angels take them. So that means Allah has given his own attributes to Muhammad that only belongs to him, which is omniscient, all knowing. Because the hadith says, whenever you supplicate, Allah will give it to me. So he's given it to him, the omniscient attributes that only Allah has. So we're asking him, when you are directing that prayer to Muhammad, can he hear you? Yes, he can. But he's not praying to Muhammad, he's praying to Allah. So it doesn't really make sense. If I'm speaking to Godwin, and I'm saying, peace be upon you, I'm speaking to him, I'm not speaking to someone else. So it's very clear that in their prayers to Allah, they're praying to Muhammad.
And that's simply it. You know, it's very clear that Muhammad is deified in Islam. And we use various sources, various texts, various Islamic scriptures to show that, listen, you are directly treating Muhammad as if he is God.
As if he's God.
Or as if he's Allah. And so what we would encourage Muslims is to come away from these lies and deceptions. Stop praying to a false God, Muhammad, and come to the true God of the Bible and the God of the universe.
Amen.
His name is Jesus.
Who is alive and he's not dead. He was dead, but now he's alive. He's the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Muslims, we want you to know we're doing this because we love you.
Yes.
Not because we hate you. Sometimes it might be tough love, but we are here so you can escape the hellfire and come to know Christ.
Amen.